Are you on? Oh, yes. Is it that bad to be eating one of these on camera? Because we know we got a bit of weird people on the web who like to twist things. Get it? What is it? Hey guys, how's it going? It's Lou here. So yes, I'm eating an ice cream. It's boiling hot here in Spain. I'm going to do a video, obviously, for you guys, and it's the 15 weird questions tag, and I have the questions on my phone here. And yeah, I just wanted to do something so you can guys get to know me a little bit better. Let's jump right into it. Question number one: what's a nickname only your family calls you? There isn't really. I mean, one that very not a lot of people call me is Luby Lou, which is something my dad always calls me, but something that only my family calls me is Bab, which is Babby, which if you're a Brummy from Birmingham, that's a word that's used quite a lot when you call somebody you love very dearly and obviously happens to be your girlfriend or your daughter or whatever. So yeah, everyone calls me Lou, which is my nickname, but that's not just my family. Everyone calls me that, so Bab or Luby Lou would be the only nickname my family calls me. Two, what's a weird habit of yours? I honestly don't know if it's weird. As you can see by watching all my YouTube videos and just basically if you meet me in person and you talk to me, I a lot. See, I'm trying not to say it now and I get stuck for words because it's something I use constantly when I'm trying to think of new things to say. And something I use a lot. Also, I bite the inside of my mouth. I've got loads of scars on the inside of my mouth where I'm constantly like this. Three, do you have any weird... oh my god, I'm gonna kill that fly. Number three, do you have any weird phobias? Again, I don't know if it's weird. You know, that's just personal. Everyone can take it however they want to take it. You could call it a phobia because I get really freaked out when these things happen, but I hate not being in control. Now that sounds weird, so I'm going to clarify that for you. It's not that, for example, relationship-wise, I have to be the one in control. No, it's not that. It's when I'm put into situations that I can't get out of, or when people gang up on you, get trying to put words in your mouth and stuff. I hate that. I get really freaked out. That's why I can't go on roller coasters, because I don't like the feeling of being trapped and that I don't have the option to leave if I don't want to be there anymore, or on a roller coaster anymore. If I'm fed up, I don't want to do it anymore. I don't even want to go down that scary slope. I can't, and that's what terrifies me. So yeah, that's a weird phobia. And as well, I might have a bit of a fear of heights, maybe, but I think a lot of people have that. But it's definitely that one I've noticed, where I'm put in situations that I don't have the control, the option to escape that situation. I don't like it. Four, what's a song you secretly love to blast and belt out when you're alone?
Take me away,
Number five, what's one of your biggest pet peeves? Over here in Spain, I haven't noticed it in the UK, but in Spain, a lot of the young men, what, just men in general, I've seen a woman do it once and it just disgusted me. The men over here have a very bad habit of just spitting on the floor. They'd like be there with the mates, hey, how's it going? Yeah. It's disgusting that they don't care if there's tons of girls around them or there are elderly people around them. It's super disrespectful. They just spit. You know, they got a bit of phlegm. Oh, just spit it here. Bleh. You know, and expect everyone to step on it. Absolutely disgusting. I hate it. Like, I really hate it. I will not date anyone who does that on the floor. And if they do, we got a problem here. Number six, what's one of your nervous habits? I would say biting my nails. I have terrible nails. It's something, I don't deliberately bite my nails, if you can understand that. It's like I do it in situations psychologically. So if I'm nervous for an exam or stuff, I'll just end up biting my nails and I'll see them, I'll go, oh, or anything. I'm watching a film and again it's very tense and everything, my hand will make its way up to my mouth and I'll just start biting my nails. It's a disgusting habit, I know. You don't know how many times I've tried to stop. I've put on the nail varnish, that tastes horrible. In the end I actually like the flavour and I just deal with it. We've tried everything. My dad keeps taking the Mickey out of me, saying he's going to put boxing gloves on my hands, but I don't know. If you guys have any, I know in the end it's willpower, but I'm doing it without me realising. It's not that I'm smoking and I know I'm smoking, you know? Seven, what side of the bed do you sleep on? My own. I tend to sleep on the, no, screw it, I sleep on all sides of the bed, upside down, left, right, up, down, and if my boyfriend is with me, I'll just push him off the bed. Eight, what was your first stuffed animal and what was its name? I don't think I had an emotional connection towards a stuffed animal. I was very attached to a blankie. It was basically a cover, a little cover with silk ends on it, and I used to take that everywhere with me, and eventually I destroyed the silk by rubbing it so much. I loved it. My mum tried to throw it out, I'd find it, take it out the bin. I was obsessed with it, I could not sleep without it. It was, my dad gave it to me the day I was born, and ever since then I was inseparable with it. And recently, I would say like 2 years back, I actually found it. And I was so emotional, it just brought back so many memories. Like, you don't realise objects or things trigger memories, a smell or even a blankie. And the name of it, well, blankie, manky blankie, because it was that disgusting. But yeah, manky blankie. What's the drink you always order at Starbucks? Well, would it be weird if I said to you that a white girl like me has never had Starbucks? I know, right? It's crazy. I went once and I don't even know what I ordered, because they ordered it for me to try my very first Starbucks drink, and it was basically an iced coffee with cream, and it was good. I don't know what it's called, but where I work in Gibraltar, there are Costa Coffee. So Costa Coffee is basically the same as Starbucks, so I get there the Frostinos. If I go to places like that, I won't get a traditional coffee, because I can get a traditional coffee somewhere else a lot cheaper. So if I go into a Costa or if I ever go into a Starbucks, I'll get something that I won't be able to get in just any cafe or whatever. So I get the smoothies they have, the ice coolers, ice fruit coolers, I think they're called in Costa, and the Frostinos. So I like the chocolate shortbread one, or the basically the iced coffee with cream. Yeah, that's basically, always get the large, of course. 10. What's the beauty rule you preach but never actually practice? Well, this is actually one my mum preaches, and she tries to get me to do it, which I think is super important to do from a young age. But again, it's just getting into that habit of doing it. I have started getting into a habit of doing it now because of the sun. Sorry, I burped there. But no, my mom preaches that you should always moisturize your face morning and night. Always moisturize your face down to your neck. My mom looks great for her age. She's got hardly any wrinkles on her face, and that's because from a very young age, her mom was constantly telling her, you know, you've got to moisturize your face all the time, morning, night, and now she's doing the same to me. And obviously, I don't know if this has anything to do with me constantly taking care of my skin, but every time I meet somebody, they never get my age right. I'm always younger, I'm never older, or I'm never my actual age, which is 19, by the way. The last two people I've met, they said I was 14. I don't know if I look that young, but look, I know I don't have boobs, and I'm quite short, and my hands are small, but come on, my face doesn't look like 14. Does it? 11. Which way do you face in the shower? I face away from it, so the water's falling on my back. I hate having water on my face. 12. Do you have any weird body skills? I have a few. I don't know if it's weird, but I'm double jointed on my knees and on my arms. I don't know if this is picking up on the camera. So that would be a normal arm, and that's mine. I'm constantly like, that's your normal one, and that's mine. I can twist it all the way there, and my hand just stays there whilst my elbow is facing downwards, and the inner part of my elbow is facing upwards. Also, I can spit out of my mouth, pretty much like Spider-Man does with his web, which is basically this. And I don't know if the camera picked that up or not, but yeah, I can secrete spit out from my tongue. 13. What's your favourite comfort food? Food that's bad, but you love to eat it anyways. Comfort food, I would say chocolate, but I rarely eat chocolate now. I don't know. Comfort food, I love, now that I live away from my mum and dad, I'd say my comfort food would be now my mum and dad's cooking. When I go back, I love sitting down at the table and eating my dad's curry on a Friday night. It really relaxes me. I just really enjoy it. But a comfort food, like if I was depressed or whatever, would probably be... See, that's a hard one, because I love food in general. I do. It'd probably be chips, crisps, or... Yeah. 14. What's a phrase or exclamation you always say? be careful what you wish for. I told you so. Sounds very vendetta type, doesn't it? Revengeful. Be careful what you wish for. I told you so. And then 15, time to sleep. What are you actually wearing? I actually don't. It depends. At home, I would just sleep in my underwear, my pants, and that's it. Because I don't care. Obviously, if my brother has a friend around, I will just have a long t-shirt on with pants underneath, of course. Obviously, with my boyfriend, just my pants again, I don't care. But here, working, again, in my pants, because there's a lock on my door. I just hate sleeping with clothes on. It's just the most uncomfortablest thing. And actually, it's very healthy to actually sleep naked. I can't do that. I've tried. It's a bit weird. But actually sleeping naked is very healthy for you. It's very good for you. I can't remember the exact reasons why, but if you go on the internet and you look it up, it actually gives you some really cool facts about why it's good to sleep with no clothes on. So anyway guys, if you enjoyed this video, please give it a big thumbs up, and if you are not a subscriber, please subscribe to my channel, it would be very much appreciated. We have now hit over 800 subscribers, and it's insane to think that that many people actually sit down and watch my videos. It's very much appreciated. If we hit, well, when we hit 1,000 subscribers, it would be awesome if you guys could leave in this video a comment just giving me ideas of what I can do to film to celebrate 1,000 subscribers. And yeah, I'll see you in the next video guys. Bye.